If you've watched my videos before, you'll know I'm a huge Canva fan. But the one big shortcoming that Canva has always had, which might change in the future, but as of the time of recording this, they do not have an exclusive category for creating eBooks or guides. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you the exact steps that I take to create my beautiful course guides for all of my students, and you can use the same strategies to create eBooks as downloadable freebies for your email subscribers, or if you want to maybe sell them as templates on platforms like Etsy and Creative Market. And at the end, I'm also going to show you how to make your PDF fillable so that people can type straight into it in case you're using this as more of a workbook rather than an ebook. And I'll show you how to make a quick and beautiful mockup of your creation so that you have an image to promote your ebook on social media or on your website or wherever else you want to promote it. The first step will be to get a little bit of inspiration. So going over to creativemarket.com can help with looking at ebooks in particular industries or just ebook designs in general, and looking at especially the internal page designs and getting a little bit of inspiration, maybe going through and taking a few screenshots. But keeping in mind, we're not going to be copying what these people have done. We're just drawing some inspiration. So for example, with this one, I might be inspired to also have this kind of archway photo in one of my designs. With this one, I might like the idea of the two paragraphs side by side, but we're not copying the internal pages. And we're also drawing inspiration from multiple designs. So you want to make sure you're doing this with 5 or 6 designs so that that eliminates the risk that you're ever going to copy one person. So you just want to make sure you're drawing some inspiration, taking a couple of example shots. If you're going to go and actually copy what someone's done, please go through and purchase it. So this is not about taking someone's hard work and claiming it as our own. It's just about gathering inspiration. Once you have your screenshots, you can come in and dump them into just a blank document like this one, so that you can use it for inspiration. You might even be able to have it on a separate screen, which is what I'm gonna do today, so that you can use it as reference while you're designing and you can have it in the future as well. So for these, I quite like the colors. I like some of the images or some of the designs, but I'm gonna be making all of them my own. So in this case, I'm just gonna go ahead and move this to the side so that I'm not looking at it on the same screen, but we're going to refer to it as we're designing. So now that I know the general look and feel of the ebook that I'm going to be doing, I went through to Unsplash and just created a folder of images that I can then download from here and upload into Canva and use for my ebook. This is just a little bit easier than going through Canva's photo library because I don't find it to be all that search friendly. Not to mention, if any of you are on a free Canva plan, you might not have access to a lot of the high quality images within Canva. So instead, you can just come into here and say something like, for this particular ebook, I would say something like Boho Home. And anytime I find an image I like, I can go through and just save it to a collection as soon as I'm signed into Unsplash. So it's completely free for you to sign up, and then you can create these collections of images. And anytime you're in an image, you're also gonna see images that are related to it just underneath. So this makes it really easy to click through and keep saving things to your collections so that you can then download that and put it into your uploads folder within Canva. Now within Canva, you will find some designs for eBooks, even multi-page designs, which is really cool. Like this one's 1 of 11, but they're generally few and far between because there's no template category for it at this stage. And also they are usually in weird dimensions. So if you're ever designing for your audience to also be able to print your designs, generally these are not designed for that. So we are going to be designing ours just from scratch by designing an A4 document so that we can get the full custom experience here and see what it's like if we're designing completely from scratch. So the first thing I want to do is lay out my document for design purposes. So I'm going to go over to File and Show Margins so that I know my text needs to be within this dotted line. And I also have my rulers and guides already on, so you can see them here. What that allows me to do is click and drag from the top and the side as well. So when it snaps into place, that pink line means that's the center of the page. And I can also move them back up if I want them to disappear. But primarily I need this to be in the center of my page vertically if I'm going to be designing with paragraphs on either side. And I also want to make sure that there's a little bit of space on either side of this for my text to be able to breathe. So this is at 10.5 is the middle of my page. So I want to go to about 9.5 on this side and about 11.5 on this side, which gives me nice little margin in the center there. So I would place my text on the left and the right side of this. So now it's time to pick our fonts. And for my heading font, I would probably go with a serif font that's a little bit more fancy, regal. I don't know. Just a little bit more kind of impactful, I suppose. And then for my body text, I'm going to go with a sans serif font, which is just quite easy to read, quite minimalistic, and makes it easy to read if you're reading quite a lot of text. So I'm quite happy with this particular serif font. And then for my body text, I could keep it at Poppins Light. I actually don't mind that one, but I've already got one in mind that plays relatively well with this particular heading font. And I would make sure I'm justifying my paragraph text because that's just how I prefer to have it. But you have to do what's right for you and whatever feels right for you. With my heading font, I would want to make sure it's, you know, on the left of this particular line. And then with my body font, it doesn't necessarily need to be too large. I just want to make sure that I'm doing a final check at the end to make sure everything is readable, of course. But for now, we're just kind of designing. If at this stage I don't have the text I want to use for my ebook, you can go to something like lipsum.com, which actually allows you to grab some kind of fake dummy text, which can just serve for the purpose of allowing you to design your document and have some text there as a placeholder, I suppose. So I would just design that to the, and then bring that to the line there and make sure my heading is kind of on top of that. And now I'm just gonna align it with the bottom here. So at any point you can hit Shift R on your keyboard, which will make the lines go away and then bring them back again. So these are not gonna be visible on your final design, of course. They're just there as placeholders just for now. And now I wanna add in an image on the right-hand side here. So I've created a folder in here and brought in all of my kind of Scandinavian images that I've collected from Unsplash so that I can make sure I'm able to bring these in even if I'm on a Canva free plan. So I don't necessarily need to be a pro user to use these. And that's looking pretty good. So let's check that without the ruler. So I'm really happy with how that's turning out. I would probably just make sure that my paragraphs have gaps in between them because that's how it would be, so that it's as close to how it'll be once I'm designing as possible. But that's my first internal page based on one of the designs that I looked at on Creative Market. So I'm just going to keep going through and doing similar things for the rest of the internal pages, and then I'm going to pause once we're going to be doing something a little bit different. Alright, so now I'm going to draw inspiration from one of the designs which had a bit of an archway like this as an image. So what I would look for is arch frame or archway frame and try and find one that will allow me to make this kind of effect happen with a photo. So I'm going to erase this, I'm going to bring in this arch, and I'm going to have it just on this side and a little bit off center, so not quite within the frame. There we go. that looks pretty good. That way I can actually make this paragraph a little bit larger and just bring it down. Bring my heading down as well. And now I can add in my photo. So let's go over back to my folder. That looks pretty good. So it's already starting to shape up pretty well. Let's have a look at all my pages. So I've just got one top, one bottom, one kind of potentially used as a quote where I would just have a little bit of text in the middle there, and then one in a little bit of an archway. So for a pretty basic ebook, I think that's probably actually enough. What I might potentially do is at the end, just add in a web address at the bottom there. So now with Canva, when you do put in any shapes, you can actually type straight into the shape. So I could say something like reallygreatsite.com, not really knowing exactly what my web address would be at this stage. And this can be quite small, and we'll make it our glacial indifference. I would play around with the letter spacing. Again, it just gives it that nice modern look by spacing that out and making sure I'm matching the color to the color of my template. So I can actually use the color picker here and maybe even pick a color straight from the image that I've used there. And that looks pretty good. I would maybe go a little bit more narrow on it. Doesn't need to be quite that large. And then now I can potentially copy this over and add it to my other pages. So it doesn't have to be on every single page, but I can add it to just a couple of the pages here. So maybe not this one. I can see it being on this one, but maybe being white with the brown text there. Maybe leave that one alone and add it to that one. Yeah, so that looks pretty good. Nice and branded. And now it's time for us to make our cover page. So I like keeping this really simple. Again, you can just draw inspiration from other designs, but I am generally the simpler the better kind of gal. So I would just go through, maybe again, color pick a color out of here for my cover page. And I'll be using a different image. I don't need all this paragraph text here. And we're just gonna be spacing this out. This can just exist here. I'm going to be adding in my web address. So I'm gonna bring that. Actually, let's bring in this one. Yep, that looks good. So I can just tidy that up. And then it would be something like title of the book goes here, not the official title, very much a working title, and making sure that's nice and center here. And then if you had maybe a subtitle or a subheading, you could add that in as well. So it could be, you know, subheading goes here. And I would again space that out a little bit to make it look nice and modern. So now my image can go almost all the way to the top. Nice, big and bold. And now we're going to actually pick the image that we want on our cover there. So let's go with something nice and simple like this here. All right, that's looking pretty good. I think this needs to go up a lot higher than that, and I think this color no longer really matches what we were trying to do here. It's probably a little bit better like that. Yep, that looks pretty good. So now we're going to add just one more page so we can take a look at how to make your PDF fillable in case you need to do that. And we could just look for something like a to-do list and keep it relatively simple. So I'm just going to select this one here and let's remove a couple of the different elements here. Change this to our existing font. And the first thing I'm going to do is just save a PNG of the cover so that we can make that into a mockup. So I'm just going to be selecting the first page, making sure that's a PNG, and downloading that. And then we're going to be downloading the rest of the ebook. Obviously, we would want to make sure all the text and everything is in there, but just for demo purposes, we're going to be downloading that as a PDF. So I want to make sure it's PDF standard, not print, unless people are going to be printing it, because it makes it a nice small file. So now to make our PDF fillable, we're going to head to pdfescape.com and then drag our PDF in there so that we can just select the fields that we need to be fillable so that people can open them up on their computer and start typing straight in. So we just need to be going to the last page here, selecting a form field. And we would continue doing that for all the fields, obviously, but at this stage, let's go ahead and save and download that. And now if someone was to open this up and go all the way to the very end, these fields are now completely fillable. Yay! So now within Canva, if you look for something like ebook mockup or book mockup, it'll come up with some ideas for social media posts that you can use. So I'm just going to go ahead and select a random one that has an iPad in it. So that might work for my purposes. And I would just want to make sure I'm dragging my image in here. Obviously, I haven't named it very well, but that's fine for our purposes. And then I can just click and drag it into the middle of the iPad. And I could just obviously change the fonts and change the text to make sense for my social media posts, but that's looking pretty good. Actually, the colors match relatively well. So that is one thing to do. Otherwise, you can actually erase this altogether, bring in your image, and then just go through to edit image, smart mockups, and then find a book mockup. So it makes it a little bit more fancy if you are using any of these kind of book mockups for your social media posts. Keeping in mind, if you're only going to be doing this as an ebook, maybe it being on an iPad will completely suffice and you don't necessarily need to make it into a full-blown mockup, but that makes it look quite cool and it makes it really captivating when it's coming across your feed on social media. If you're using your ebook to grow your email list and you want people to be able to sign up and actually download your ebook, I can really recommend checking out this video over here, which is all about my favorite inexpensive email marketing tool for small business owners. So make sure to check that out. And if you'd like to check out my full Canva course and learn more about this amazing tool, check out the links in the description of the video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did and you could give it a like and subscribe to the channel, that would really help me out. Thank you so much for being here and watching this video. Have an amazing rest of your day, and I'll see you in the next one.